Hello and welcome to the Kitchen Club. Today we are going to speak about organizing the fridge. 5 easy steps that can help you keep your fridge always clean. Also make it very manageable. Find things easily in the fridge. Never lose that box of mashed potato which you need badly but you're not able to find it in the fridge. Also, this would ensure that the things are lasting for a longer duration of time because we are going to store it thoughtfully. The first step is always line your shelves with these anti-slip sheets. These are easily available in the market. This makes sure that it doesn't stain your shelves. Also, cleaning them is very easy. Replace them once in 3 months to make sure they are in good condition. Moving on to the second point, always store your things in the fridge based on their cooling needs. The first tray or the chilled tray in the fridge is the coolest place, which is best for storing dairy products like butter, cheese, spreads, egg, yogurt. It makes sure they remain fresh for longer time. The second shelf can be for dosa batter and food leftovers, and going down the shelves could be for fruit and vegetables. The vegetables stay fresh for longer in the crisper box because you can easily adjust the humidity settings. And also the fruits can be stored in such rectangular baskets. Moving to the third step, no poly bags inside the fridge. Make sure you're storing all your leftovers, the dosa batter, in such see-through boxes, which makes it very easy to locate which item is stored in which box. As you can see, these boxes are flat and they don't occupy too much of the height of the shelves, which makes it easier to store more boxes in less space. Moving on to the fourth point, storing vegetables and fruits. Make sure you're washing all the vegetables and fruits and storing them. Except for fruits such as grapes and berries, which become soggy if they are washed and stored in the fridge. Believe me guys, this saves so much of time while you're cooking. You can directly pick up vegetables and the green stuffs from your fridge and directly start cooking. Moving on to the fifth step, storing the greens like curry leaves, green chilies, coriander, spinach, lettuce, mint. Everything should be washed, cleaned, wiped dry. Make sure there is no moisture left in them and then store into such clear boxes and put it in your fridge. This again is a great time saver guys. When you're cooking, you can directly pick up things from your fridge and use it in your dishes. As you can see, the green chilies, the mint, the coriander, everything has been washed well and dried for sufficient time to make sure there is no moisture left in them and store it in the fridge. Now let me quickly run you through the fridge door. I keep the beverages like milk, juice bottles here, all the sauces, the condiments, the pickles, the ginger garlic paste, all goes into the fridge door. In the freezer top shelf is the ice tray, the ice creams, and in the next shelf is the frozen vegetables, fruits, and the frozen peas. Once the frozen items have been taken and opened up, I store them in the Ziploc packs like this, and it is a good idea to note down the expiry days and the date when you have opened the bags. The freezer door contains of some frozen grated coconut and grated ginger, which can be stored for almost 1 week. This can be used in curries, and the grated ginger goes into the tea every day. And as you can see, I have also stored some spices here, which I don't use very often. This can be stored in the fridge for almost 1 year. And some dry fruits, which I have in excess. After the ones that I have stored in the pantry, the remaining have been stored in the freezer. So that's it friends. This is how I organize my fridge. And even after storing so many things, you can see there are still so much of space left for storing other things. Like here in the chill tray, I can store few more boxes of yogurt, and in the second shelf I have still some space for one more flat box above this one, and also there is some space to store more boxes in the right side, as you can see. If you think these tips and steps were useful for you, give this video a big thumbs up. And don't forget to share it with your friends. I'll see you next time in my next video. Till then, goodbye.